I'll start with a new blank presentation in Microsoft PowerPoint. But the first thing I need to do is to create the background, the grid that I'm going to use to measure my drawing. So I'll go here to the very bottom, and with a shift key down, click on that little button there that hovers, says normal, and I'll bring up the master style editor. What we need here is just none of these presets that they give you as layouts. So I will simply select all of the items that are on this page and delete them. I don't want any of them. Then the first thing I'm going to do is to go and find my line tool. Insert shapes and find the line. And I'm going to go about a half an inch in and right at the top border and draw a straight line. If you hold down the shift key, it forces it into a straight line, and release. Then right click on that line and choose size and position. Here we want really position, so we want it a half an inch in the horizontal and we want it at zero. And the size we want at 7.5 inches, that's just fine. Then with that selected, I'll do a Control D for duplicate, and it gives me a new one, but it's not quite in the right position. So I'll right click on that one and choose size and position. Go to position. On the horizontal, we want that in at 1 inch. Let's go and also get the vertical and make that zero on this one. So it's right there next to the other one. Now with luck, we can just march across the page with the Control D. Since we've set the first two up, we can go on across. If you happen to mess that up, yeah, you'll just have to resize and reposition each one of them. Then with the vertical lines drawn, let's go back to the Shapes menu, go get another line, and this time we're going to go and go about right here, about a half an inch down, and go straight across for the entire width of the page. Again, we'll right click on that, choose size and position. Width is 10 inches, that's fine. Managed to get that right. And horizontal zero, but we want this at about a half an inch on the vertical, and close. So now we have the first part of our grid. We want to, while that's selected, could do a Control D, then right click, again choose size and position. Position, make the horizontal zero. The vertical, let's go 1 inch in, or 1 inch down, and we're now down. So with that still selected, do a Control D, and it will again march on down the page, position it every half an inch. Now for the very bottom one, let's give ourselves a few hints, and let's right click on that and choose the line settings. Let's make that, say, a bright red. And let's make that also a heavier weight, let's say 3 points, to indicate a bottom. Let's do the same thing in the center with the zero line, essentially making it red and making it 3 points. Those are the main lines that we're going to use. Just for convenience, so that we can remember what we're about here, let's choose a text box, and I'm just going to do a minimal part of this right now, but I'm going to mark that this line is 1 inch or 2 inches. Now that's too big, so let's shrink it down a little bit and center it, and we can make it maybe a little bit bigger. So that's Radius wise, that's 1 inch out from the center, but diameter wise, that's 2 inches. So with that, I'm going to duplicate that again and go out here, change this to say that this is 2 inches in radius wise and 4 inches diameter wise. Do it again, 6 inches radius, or 4 inches radius, 6 inches diameter wise. And another one to make this is a 6 inch radius or 8 inch in diameter. Then I'll select all of these and use the alignment tool that I keep on the toolbar to straighten them all out. I only really care about one side of this drawing, but with this I would also generally go up the middle, marking the heights of the bar also. I'll leave that as an exercise for you to do. So this should be enough for us to use over and over again as a background to background layout to our drawings. Let's go back to standard slide mode, go down here to the bottom icon, do a shift, or just do no shift, and do a click, and now we are here in this. There's a couple of vestiges of stuff that was there from the previous layout. Let's get rid of those, and now we have our grid. And if you notice, I can click on any of these lines and I'm not selecting them because they are on the master layout. So now let's just do a bit of a drawing. Again, I'm going to go up and use the shapes tool. This time I want to go get the, hover over this, and this is the freeform tool. Now you can use this a number of ways. You can draw, it'll actually draw fairly good curves for you if you hold down the button, mouse button, as you drag the mouse. But I found that that gives me too many data points and actually makes it harder to do. So what I'm going to do is just to start here and draw initially only straight lines. So I'll go to the center where I want to start, and I'm going to go out about, in this case, to about 3 inches in diameter, and I'll do another single click. That'll be part of my base. Then in this case, I'm going to go down to the very baseline and do another click, then come out about a half an inch, do another click, and then that will define my bottom of my bowl. And then I'm going to come up and say, let's put a point there, let's point a point there, and let's put a point here at about 9 inches in diameter or 7 inches in radius. That point I'm going to say, okay, that's my lip, and do another point, come back and just do straight lines here until I get back to the middle, and then a double click finishes the drawing. So I have half of a bowl shape. Now you may say, well, those are just straight lines. It may well be that a straight line is all you need, but if you really want the curves, with the shape selected, and right click on one of the lines and choose this edit points tool. What we're going to do now is just hover over one of the lines in the drawing, right click, and choose curved segments. So now this segment between these two points is actually a curve instead of a straight line. We'll do that on another one, and we'll do this on this last one, make them all curved segments. Now the difference is now that if you click on one of these points, you see two little handle squares show up, and by manipulating these you can actually change the curve to make it more of a curve, less of a curve, whatever, and adjust those to your heart's content. If you find that you have too many points drawn, as you know, for example, if you actually held down the mouse while you were drawing, you'd have hundreds of points. You can right-click on the point and say, I want to delete that point, and that will replace it with just a line. Now, sometimes it makes the line straight again, so let's go and, oh, that's still a curve. Now, click on the bottom handles, pull up the handles, and we can draw our curve just with that. And similarly on the top, as much as we want to refine the shape, we can do it with these little in the edit points mode. So let's say that we're happy with this now, this half bowl now, and we want to see what it looks like overall. So we'll select the bowl. I'm going to duplicate it. I like the keyboard keys for duplicate. So it's given me another copy of that, and I will go up and find, I keep it on my toolbar, the rotate. What I want to do is to flip this other piece horizontally. Then I'll, the keyboard, move it over or drag it with the mouse, and that's my other half bowl. You can waste a lot of time trying to draw a bowl perfectly symmetrical. I don't bother, I just draw the half and then replicate it to the other side. Let's say that we're now happy with the shape of this bowl. That's about what we want. It does leave room for artistic interpretation later as we're on the lathe, but let's now make the segments. So to do this, I'm going to go up to the Shapes toolbar and grab a rectangle and come down, and I want to draw a rectangle that is maybe a half an inch by an inch and a half as my starting point. Now to confirm this, I'm going to go in again to right click and size and position, and I want to make sure that this height is a half an inch and the width is an inch and a half. But what I also want to do while I'm here is I want to go into the fill, and I'm going to move the transparency slider over to about 50%, plus or minus to taste, and I want to color that, say, orange. So now my segments are orange, my wood segments are orange, my target bowl is the deeper blue in this case. If I'm using multiple colors of wood, I could have different colors of segments, and since they're half transparent, you can see the bowl through it. If they're on top of the bowl, or you can see them behind the bowl if they're behind. And so with that as being, say, my preferred standard measure, I will now duplicate that segment, move it up, maybe move it over a little bit, duplicate it again, that looks good. Duplicate it again, I need to move that and over a little bit, maybe more to here. Duplicate it again, move this over, and duplicate it again up to there. Now it looks like, with the way that that curve is flaring out, that that segment will not do. So I'll actually pull that out and make that a little bit wider. That will now need to be 1/2, 1, 1.5, and maybe it needs to be a full 2-inch wide segment. This bottom one also, maybe that needs to be made a little bit larger, and we can probably make that work with, again, a 2-inch wide segment. One thing I would also intend to do on my template is to number these as they come up so that I know how many layers that I have. So there you have it, a way to use PowerPoint to make a segmented drawing. From this, simply take your start your layer diagram, your layer worksheet. From the diagram, you can measure the inner diameter and outer diameter and width of every segment, however you want to calculate it. Plot it out, calculate your segment lengths and widths, and go on from there. So this is how I've been pushing PowerPoint to do segmented drawings. I have no argument with the commercially available segmented design tools, except that with my background in computer science, it's been my whole career, I've been using, designing, or programming, and I like to use the software that I have to the fullest extent possible before I go on and buy something else that has a lot of other bells and whistles. So there you have it, and happy turning.